Tuberculosis mostly affects the lungs, and it's transmitted through the air. So if I have tuberculosis and I cough in your face, you might be infected with tuberculosis. Before we had new drugs, there was an 80% chance of death over 5 years in patients with extensively drug-resistant TB.
There was almost nothing we could do for these cases.
Developing a drug for TB is not necessarily a profitable venture. The costs are very high, and the profit to be made is quite low, because the people who need the drugs can't usually pay for them, and the people who have the money don't need them.
The task just happened because we were approached by a drug company that had discovered a new potential tuberculosis drug, and they were looking around for people who could help them test it. We here were the only ones that had the capacity to actually do this.
We are currently doing a study where we're treating patients with XDR-TB with a novel combination of three drugs for 6 months. Previously, 80% of XDR patients would die. Now 80% of XDR patients get cured.
We have to treat tuberculosis always with at least three drugs, because we know that the bacteria find a way to mutate and become resistant to a single drug. We nowadays have every 20th patient that we diagnose does have some form of drug resistance.
Drug-resistant tuberculosis is categorized into multi-drug-resistant TB and extensively drug-resistant TB.
So if we can no longer use the standard drugs for drug-sensitive TB, we have to use the so-called second line or third line drugs. These patients do have longer treatment durations with drugs that are not very easy to take.
22 tablets every day, Monday to Sunday.
The second line drugs that can be injected, they cause deafness in a large proportion of people. People are nauseous, they feel tired, they just cause pain. So these drugs do work, but they have many side effects as well. Our role is to test new drug candidates and find new ways how the people can be treated. It is possible to find new drugs for tuberculosis. If I can claim one thing for myself, it's not that I invented the new drugs or that I bring the new drugs to the patients. That's all other people that do that. I've basically convinced people to get up and try something new. And sometimes that's all it takes.